In my last video, I talked about SSH and how to set up SSH using key-based authentication method. And in that video, I mentioned about creating a private key using a passphrase and how to use it to establish a connection. So I'm creating this video just to demonstrate how to create a private key and protect with the passphrase and log in using passphrase. So if you have not seen that video where I explained in detail how SSH works and how to set up SSH authentication, you should go and check out that video. I'll put a link on the top right corner. Like I mentioned in my previous video, SSH is disabled by default in Kali Linux. So let's go ahead and start that service real quick. Sudo systemctl start SSH service. Now we can do sudo system status. Let's go ahead and check my IP address. Now let's go to the client and create a new pair of private and public key with the passphrase. This is it. Keygen. Authentication. So this is the default location for the private key. And enter the passphrase. So let me enter the passphrase that I want to use to protect my private key. So now inside this folder, the new private key and public key pair is created. Now we created a new private key and public key pair. So what I have to do is I have to copy this new public key to the server using SSH copy ID utility. So let's do that. ID, username of the remote server, and IP address. So asking me for the password of the remote server. So the key is added. Now if I want to make SSH connection, 192.16.10.7. So now it is asking me to enter my passphrase to unlock the private key, which we just created. So it gave me access to the server. And if I want to make a connection again, then the connection is established. But let's say if I exit out of this session and log out, so now let's open a new terminal and try to establish SSH connection to the server. ssh-add/32.16.10.7. It is asking me for the passphrase again. So what you can do is you can use, let's go ahead and cancel this one. Now it is asking me to log in using user password instead of SSH key-based authentication because I refuse to give the private key passphrase. So it lets me log in using password authentication method. So you can use SSH add command to add the passphrase in your terminal and save it so that it does not prompt you when you try to make an SSH connection. So SSH add, and it is asking me for the passphrase of my private key. So enter that. And now my identity is added. Now if I want to make a SSH connection, 192.16.10.7, it should not ask me for the prompt. There you go. But if you log out again, and log back in, SSH it is asking me again because the SSH add command will only save the password for that current session. So if you log out, then you have to type it again. And if you're using GUI version of Red Hat Enterprise Linux as a client, then you can also save that password whenever you log in. So you're giving authorization to unlock the private key when you log in. So you can click that, unlock, and now you're logged in. So exit out of it. Now log out one more time. Try to log back in and do one more attempt to make an SSH connection. There you go. Because we gave authorization to unlock when we log in and open the private key and started the communication. So this is how you can use passphrase to protect your private key. Or let's say, for example, you want to remove the passphrase, then what you can do is you can use SSH keygen command and your encryption type. And you can use -p to change the passphrase or remove the passphrase. So this is the file. And it is asking to enter the old passphrase. You can enter the new passphrase, but if you want to remove it, just hit enter, enter. And now your passphrase is removed. So now you can just do SSH without the passphrase. So that's how you can add passphrase. Use ssh-add command to remember the passphrase, or you can choose to unlock your private key when you log in if you have a GUI option available. And you can remove the passphrase using ssh keygen command. So I just wanted to add that little command with my previous SSH video and wanted to make it short and quick. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.